I'm sorry. I can't explain to you how very much this ministry means to me and what I see every day that the Lord's done. I can honestly tell you that I remember every one of the clients that are with me today and the staff, as a matter of fact, when they came into the program. And I've seen what God's done in their lives. A couple of them, like myself, have been in the program more than once. Oh, that's pretty cool. Okay. He put a note up for me, so, or somebody did. Okay, so I can't stand hearing my own voice, so that's probably why I was holding it down. But I myself am actually a graduate of Adult and Teen Challenge. I actually graduated from the program in Michigan, and I went through the program with our CEO, Robert Pavlich, and probably about 10 years after I graduated, the Lord blessed me with an amazing woman of God, and I received my pastoral credentials, and I was serving as a pastor at the Teen Challenge where I graduated. Some circumstances just developed. I left that church, or left the ministry and went to work at a church, and then got caught up in the world a little bit. And when I went off track, Pastor Bobby didn't think twice and got up there to Michigan, got me down here, and I've now been here going on 10 years, so praise God. And I thank the Lord every single day for the Teen Challenge that I graduated from in Michigan, but our program is a little different than a lot of Teen Challenges now, and I've actually seen the transition. People are used to hearing Adult and Teen Challenge or to the traditional Teen Challenge, but it's the Hope Counseling and Addiction Services part on the end that people maybe aren't as familiar with. And what that is we have every bit of spiritual aspect that Teen Challenge has ever had, because we all know that Jesus Christ is the ultimate answer to everything problem we will ever encounter. And God is a true healer and a deliverer, but that doesn't mean that by our own flesh and our own mistakes that we can't turn back again. And with the Hope Counseling and Addiction Services at our program, we are able to offer licensed therapists and counselors and CDCA-led groups where you can actually learn how to work through these issues and these problems that the Lord has delivered you from to help ensure that you don't turn around. And I can honestly tell you that I do believe from the bottom of my heart that if I had gone through, or if I had offered to me the type of program we now offer when I was originally a client at Teen Challenge, there would have never been a need for a restoration. And I believe that's part of the reason the Lord has me here, because I've seen both ways, and I praise God for both ways. But I see the value in what's been added to our program. And I'm not gonna talk too long, because I think there's a lot more important things you need to be hearing, and all of them are right now wondering which ones of them I'm gonna call on. Because I never decide until the Lord tells me while I'm up here or during praise and worship. And so I've asked them all if they're okay talking, but none of them know who I'm going to pick. So they're all wondering. But I, first and foremost, before I start calling people up to speak with you, I want to thank you. I want to thank you for the opportunity of being here last year and what it did for our lives and for our ministry. I want to thank you for being able to come back. And I want to thank you for the support of our ministry. And most importantly, when I say support, I mean your thoughts and your prayers, because there is nothing more that you can ask for than the prayers of righteous men and women of God. And we need that so deeply and so much. And I just praise you and I thank you for every one of your prayers. They are felt on a daily, daily basis. And I just also want to let you know that you are always welcome to come down. We would love to see some of you guys. We're not that far. It took us 40 minutes to get here this morning. And coming up on March 18th, we actually have our monthly family day, which is also the day that if there's anybody graduating that month, they graduate. And we have one of the graduates with us today. We were supposed to have two graduates, but there's two graduating. But Sister Jamie wasn't feeling so well this morning, so she wasn't able to make it with us. And we would just love to have you come down, see a little bit of what our facility's like, maybe learn even a little more, because God is blessing us. And we, some amazing things are going on there, just like we're blessed to see that they are here. And we would love to share that with you out in the lobby after service, there's a table that's got brochures. It's got connect cards so that you can stay in touch with the ministry. We can get you put on our emailing list. We send out a monthly newsletter every month, and if there's any special events or anything coming up, we'll notify you that way as well. There'll also be several of our students and a couple of our staff members at the table, and feel free to speak with them, because no matter who I call on to speak today, there is not a testimony more powerful, because every one of them is a testimony of the healing power of Jesus Christ. Amen? And so whoever I feel led to call on today, pick the brains of every other one of them, okay? Because I promise you, every one of them is going to grab hold of your heart, and I praise God for that. And I'm just going to go ahead and get started, if that's okay with you. And like I said, none of them know who's going to get called on, well, except Marguerite, I told her, because the Lord laid it on my heart right not long before praise and worship was over. And I feel really bad because they're not sitting that well for how I'm going to call on them either. Brother Robert, would you mind coming up, please? And to let y'all know, I was telling you that we have two people graduating on March 18th, and Brother Robert is going to be one of those graduates, and it has been an honor to get to know him this year. This is truly, truly, truly just a good guy, and from the moment you meet him, you can tell that, and I praise God for him.
Thank you. Good morning. Thank you guys for having us, for sure. My name is Rob Cummings. I grew up actually in Newcastle, not far from here. Typical upbringing, I come from a pretty large family, all of which are pretty spread out, but, you know, got good grades, basically, played sports and everything growing up. Started getting into a little bit of trouble in high school, and then chose to actually move down south. I started working, doing electricity, industrial electricity down there with my father. Continued to sort of do my own thing. I got saved at the age of 7 in an old church basement in Newcastle. My father was a preacher, had a proper upbringing and knowledge of who Jesus was and everything, just never really followed it fully. But, you know, make a long story short, basically, when I was in South Carolina, just continued to do my own thing, worked hard, did a pretty good job as an electrician and everything, got married young, you know, had a couple kids and everything, but just still wasn't following the call. So, you know, we basically, you know, everything was fine. After about 7 years, I got divorced. You know, kept working, stayed focused for the most part, but just started to drink and everything. And it got just heavier and heavier as the years went on, to the point where it started to affect my health, pancreatitis, sclerosis of the liver, lost a lot of weight, just wasn't taking care of myself at all. And it just affected my whole entire life. But I had a praying mother and a praying family who knew what the end result basically would be. They were steady praying for me, never gave up, always supportive, never judged me or, saw me as like a lost cause or anything like that. They just always knew that God's hand was on my life and that eventually, I would come back to the faith and the calling that was on my life. So, basically I just came to a point of surrender. My health was so bad and my life was just going downhill. I just could do nothing else but surrender. My mother came down to visit and saw that I was in pretty bad shape. And so we flew back here to Newcastle and I came almost immediately to Teen Challenge. And from there, God just began to deal with my mind. Started to transform my thoughts, and the way it worked out, like I just dove right in, like I had no resistance whatsoever. just got into the Word, started digging into the truth of what transformation really is, and so with God's help and through the Spirit, He just enabled me. He gave me the strength and the patience and the audacity to want more of what He had for me. And so I just received it and surrendered everything. And the staff, you know, was just there at every beck and call anytime you needed to talk to anybody or anything, or needed information or whatever. Between them and God and my family, he was able to transform my way of thinking into positive thoughts and things that were going to catapult me into a bright future. So one of my favorite scriptures is 2 Timothy 1:7. For God has not given us a spirit of fear, but power, love, and a sound mind. So I appreciate that. God bless you.
Brother Sam, could you come up? Brother Sam's a pretty awesome guy. He honestly has a heart about the size of his body. I've actually known him since I came into to Ohio Valley Teen Challenge. That's the issue of having been in more than one teen challenge. But he was actually a staff member when I initially came in, and he was really there for me at the time. But I'd like you all to take some time to listen to Brother Sam.
Good morning. My name is Sam. My name is Sam. I'm from Youngstown, Ohio. I'm 42. And I came from a pretty good family. My parents, really good people, kind of, you know, gave me the blueprint on how to live life and be successful and be a loving family, but I chose to kind of go my own route. You know, as a kid, a teenager pretty much, you know, never really had any friends, always had a problem making friends, so I would do anything to fit in and make friends, which led to a lot of compromises in my life, and, you know, started with, you know, smoking weed and drinking alcohol, which led, you know, as I got older, into a drug addiction that was so bad that I couldn't manage my own life. It was horrible. And, you know, I have a daughter. And, you know, as much as you love your kids or people in your family, once you get, you know, hooked on the dope, like, no matter how much you love them, they can't keep you. Like, it just doesn't work like that. And came to Teen Challenge, graduated, stayed on staff, and held a pretty high position of leadership while I was there for about 6 years. And I decided that I wanted to leave to pursue a relationship and to pursue more money, and that led to more compromise. And then my life got out of control again, so now I end up at Teen Challenge again now with a set of consequences that really don't feel good at all. But I'd rather face those than to be out there trying to get the next fix, trying to see who I'm gonna spin into the next web of lies. And I'm just so thankful that God has taken me out of that. And slowly but surely, he'll restore all those relationships with my family and everyone else. And I thank God for that. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Praise God.
I'm so proud of you. I am so proud of Brother Sam. I don't think he even realizes how proud I am of him. But right now, I'd like to call up another individual who I'm really excited to hear from, and I have not heard from before, Sister Jennifer. And I think she's from close to here, too. And she has notes.
Hi, everyone. My name is Jennifer, and I'm 39 years old. I'm from Dubois, Pennsylvania. I have two siblings and two wonderful parents who provided everything I needed and wanted, but my parents were also strict, which eventually led me to rebel against them. In fifth grade, I ended up with an eating disorder, which I carried on throughout my adulthood. At the age of 16, I experienced sexual trauma, which led me feeling not worthy and enough, and having low self-esteem and having multiple sex partners. I started drinking at the age of 18 every day, which I was 20, when I was 20 years old, 21 years old, I found out I was pregnant with my daughter, who is 18 years old now. I stopped drinking, but after 2 years, I started drinking again. But that was not enough, so it turned into me wanting something more. At the age of 38, I was introduced to meth, coke, ecstasy, and Molly by my significant other, where the relationship was abusive and being controlled by him. The drugs eventually made me feel good and became my god. I overdosed 4 times and ended up in the psych ward multiple times and had 2 suicide attempts where I held the gun to my head. Held the gun to my head and pulled the trigger, but the bullet got stuck in the chamber. Things began to get worse, and I ended up getting arrested for the first time. I was also sentenced to teen challenge instead of prison time. I was very against staying, so I left after stirring up trouble due to jail mentality and wanting out. And I was sent back to jail, and the court ordered to teen challenge for a year. I came back with a different mindset, but I thought I would end up leaving again. God softened my heart, and I started seeking God more and more. I started reading my Bible and wanting to know more about him. He got a hold of my heart, realizing I needed a savior. I started to feel worthy and confident in who God says I am. I know God has a better plan for me than what I had in mind. Since being in Teen Challenge, my relationship with my parents is healthier, and I also have restoration with my daughter. Until God is enough, nothing will ever be.
I can tell you something from personal experience. The very first time you share your testimony, it's not easy at all, and I am very proud of you. I kind of teased her a little bit on the way down, but you did great. As a matter, I can't even explain the first time I shared my testimony. It was pretty rough. And now we have time for one more, and I think this person's not even expecting it at all. But Brother Josh, I'd like you to come up, please. And I think Josh helped you do something on your website today, too.
Yeah. Thank you. Yeah, when I came in, they asked about your website. So it's significant that I helped change your website, and God's changing my internal website, I can tell you that. So I was born in Florida in 86, so I'm 36. And I was born to a drug-addicted birth mother. I have 2 other biological siblings. We were split up, put into foster care, and never knew each other. I've come to find out that my brother was addicted as well, and now he's a pastor. So God has had a significant impact on my biological family. And I always felt that because, see, for me, I got pulled out of foster care and adopted by really good parents. So it was not a parent thing. You know, I was blessed. And I grew up in a home that prayed, and I knew who God was. It wasn't a question of, do you believe in God? The question was, I didn't want to do what God wanted me to do. Because as my adopted family would say, they were over here, and I was always right here. I wanted your love, but I didn't trust you to go inside that circle. And God has always been right over here, pulling me in, and I'm like, no, not me. Because right here, all I knew was survive. I went from school to school, and God kept pulling, you know. He pulled me out of public school where I was humiliated, teased, made fun of all. Put me in a private school, taught me the word. I didn't want anything to do with that. So I went to college. My idea was to party and drink. God's idea was to send me to a Christian college where I learned more about the Word. Didn't like that. So I think we talked about some individual from YWAM. I had friends from there. And they were like, you should go out there. And I'm like, no, not me. God's got nothing for me, okay? My goal was to get as many degrees as possible and find my identity in a title, money, and relationships. I wrecked every relationship. I blew all my money. And no matter how many degrees I gathered, I was still lonely, depressed, to a point where I wanted to die. Came into Teen Challenge in 2019. I was like, I'm only staying 30 days. And every day, worship hit me, and I heard for the first time this still small voice inside me say, stay. I got something great for you. Well, when I was walking out the door after 30 days, Brother David was like, I don't think you should go. Well, that's all right. I think I'm going to go out there and try again. A couple more years of depression, losing everything. Parents are having nightmares of when I'm going to be dead. And I'm back. This time, what they said up here about dropping that anxiety, I never felt better than when I put my hands up. Because I was over here like this, closed off. And I couldn't receive God's love like this. I had to be like this. So I thank you guys for having us. And it's a miracle. Thank you.
And now that I've made everybody get up and down and up and down, I need everybody to come on up. You too, John. And Brother Jacob, are you in here somewhere? And what I would like to do now is ask for the honor and the privilege of us being able to pray for you. If anybody feels led, if they have anything on their hearts that they need prayer for, please come up. We're going to be paired up all the way across here with our prayer partners. And just please feel free to come up and let us know what you would like prayer for, and it would be no greater honor than to pray for you. Amen?
Here is where I lay it down, every burden, every crown. This is my surrender. Here is where I lay it down, every lie and every doubt. This is my surrender. Here is where I lay it down, every burden, every crown. This is my surrender. This is my surrender. Here is where I lay it down, every lie and every doubt. This is my surrender. And I will make room for you to do whatever you want to do whatever you want to. And I will make room for you. to do whatever you want to. To do whatever you want to. Here is where I lay it down, every burden, every crown. This is my surrender. This is my surrender. Here is where I lay it down, every lie and every doubt. This is my surrender. And I will make room for you to do whatever you want to. To do whatever you want to. I will make room for you to do whatever you want to. To do whatever you want to. And I will make room for you to do whatever you want to. To do whatever you want to. And I will make room for you to do whatever you want to. To do whatever you want to. And shake up the ground of all my tradition. Break down the walls of all my religion. Your way is better. Your way is better. Break up the ground of all my tradition. Break down the walls of all my religion. Your way is better.
Your way
is better. Shake up the ground of all my tradition. Break down the walls of all my religion. Your way is better. Your way is better. Shake up the ground of all my tradition. Break down the walls of all my religion. Your way is better. Your way is better. And I will make room for you to do whatever you want to. To do whatever you want to. And I will make room for you to do whatever you want to. To do whatever you want to. And I will make room for you to do whatever you want to. To do whatever you want to.
Is it okay? I have some words of knowledge.
I will make room for you to do whatever you want to. To do whatever you want to.
All right, so this morning I was just in prayer for you guys, and I just got a couple words of knowledge as I was hearing God for the service for some body parts that God wants to heal. He wants to release the miraculous. It's a part of Jesus's reward that he paid for it by his blood. And Jesus, we say you're worthy of your full reward of healing body, soul, and spirit, and that we know that we're going to see the righteousness of God fulfilled in the body, that we will be more convinced of your righteousness than we will of our pain or our sickness. So, hey, I'm going to call out a couple things, and if it's you, just come up, and we're going to pray. Our ministry team will pray for you. So there's just, if you have anything wrong with your left hip, anybody with a left hip pain or left hip issue, sciatica, if you have a sciatica in your body, neuropathy, pain in the feet, if you have neuropathy or pain in your feet, please come forward. Migraines. God is delivering people of migraines. Actually, even check your body now, even before anybody prays for you. I feel like, hey, God's work is effortless. If he's the one doing it, it's effortless. We don't have to try hard. Pain in the neck, pain in the neck. Left ear, just go to anybody here. They're going to pray. They're all equipped to pray. I will pray too. Pain in the neck. Hey, sir, come here. Here, I release, just to release a testimony too. What happened?
Okay, well, I've been suffering a couple of days. I got this pain in my left hip. And I don't know what it was. I don't know what caused it. I didn't, like, injure myself or anything. But, man, when I'm up there playing, I'd turn like this, and it would be like a stabbing knife, and it would almost cripple me. I'd touch the spot, and it was like it would drop me. And I'm pressing it all around, and it feels a million times better. I can touch it, and it's not taking me down. It's great. It's good. Thank you.
Yeah, he said, hey, I heard that you said something's wrong with the left part of somebody's body here. It's me. I wrote this at 10 a.m. And this is for the whole body. So left ear and pain in the neck, and then that's it. All right.
So shake up the ground of all my tradition, break down the walls of all my religion. Your way is better, your way is better. Shake up the ground of all my tradition, break down the walls of all my religion. Your way is better, your way is better. Shake up the ground, all my tradition, break down the walls of all my religion. Your way is better, your way is better, and I will make room for you to do whatever you want to do whatever you want to, and I will make room for you to do whatever you want to do whatever you want to.
We got another testimony here.
I've been having pain in my left knee for the past couple months now. And they just prayed over it, and it's at zero out of 10 pain level. Woo!
And all praise to the Lord Most High, all praise to the one who saved my life, all praise to Jesus Christ, High King of Heaven, my King forever. High King of Heaven, my King forever.
You gave
your life for mine, nailed to the cross, you crucified all of my sin and shame. It was washed by your mercy. treasure I find, my reason for living. So let my life become an offering to the one who is worthy. All praise to the Lord Most High. All praise to the one who saved my life. All praise to Jesus Christ, High King of Heaven, my King forever. All praise to the Lord Most High. All praise to the one who saved my life. All praise to Jesus Christ, High King of Heaven, my King forever. You storm the gates of my heart. The veil in between was torn apart. Now you hold the keys to the grave, 'cause you bring things to life. You roll stones away. All praise to the Lord Most High. All praise to the one who saves my life. All praise to Jesus Christ, High King of Heaven, my King forever. All praise to the Lord Most High. All praise to the one who saved my life. All praise to Jesus Christ, High King of Heaven, my King forever. My hands up, lay my whole life down, my whole life down before you. I lift my hands up, lay my whole life down, my whole life now is for you. And I lift my hands up, lay my whole life down, my whole life down before you. And I lift my hands up, lay my whole life down, my whole life now is for you. And I lift my hands up.
We have a testimony up here. Listen up. Excuse me.
It's on. It's on.
It's 100%. 100%.
It's on.
Turn. Oh, it died.
Oh, okay. All right. Excuse me. We have a testimony. So if we can just listen up for a second, please.
Hi. I came up with my back and hip hurting and neck, and it's gone. So thank you.
And I feel like there's somebody that has been away from God that has a prodigal story, but you happen to be here on this Sunday, that needs to come and get prayed for. That you have a prodigal story, that you grew up, you knew God, but you've just been away from him for some time. Please just come up. If it's going to take some courage, but your breakthrough is today. Your breakthrough and your healing is today. And then I have a word for Elisa. If there's Elisa here, Elisa or Linda, please come up.